Air India Express has sacked at least 30 cabin crew, a day after nearly 300 employees of the airlines called in sick and switched off their phones, leading to a large-scale flight disruption. The number of job terminations is likely to increase. The management sources said has given an ultimatum to the employees to join work by 4 p.m. today or face action. A total of 74 flights have been cancelled today as the disruption snowballed into a full-blown crisis for the low-cost airline, which is a subsidiary of Air India, now owned by Tata Group. The employees have been protesting against the new employment terms, sources have said. The crew, the sources said, has alleged a lack of equality in the treatment of staff. They have claimed that some staff members have been offered lower job roles despite clearing interviews for senior positions, the sources said. The crew has also flagged some modification in their compensation package. This development has taken place even as the airline is in the middle of a merger with AIX Connect, formerly Air Asia India. The Air India Express crisis in fresh trouble for the Tata Group barely a month after its full-service carrier Vistara witnessed disruption due to protest by pilots over a host of issues, including their rostering for flights and change in their pay packages. In a statement, Air India Express has said it is making every possible efforts to minimize the inconvenience caused to our guests by this unexpected situation, and they will be operating 292 flights today. They have mobilized all resources and Air India will support them by operating on 20 of their routes. However, 74 of their flights stand cancelled and they urge their guests booked a flight with them to check if their flight is affected by the disruption before heading to the airport. If their flight is cancelled or delayed beyond 3 hours, they may opt for a full refund or reschedule to a later date without any fees on TIA, on WhatsApp number or on airindiaexpress.com. The termination letter issued to the 30 old crew members says that the must leave clearly points to a premeditated and concerted absentation from work without any justifiable reason. As a result of the above, a large number of flights had to be cancelled, thereby disrupting the entire schedule, which caused tremendous inconvenience to the company's esteemed passengers. In a letter, they said, "Your act is not only subversive of public interest, but has also caused embarrassment, severe reputational damage and serious monetary loss to the company. Your act of reporting sick for work amounts to a concerted action with a common understanding. Do not operate the flight and to disrupt services of the company. This is not only in violation of the applicable laws but also violates the Air India Express Limited employees." The Air India Express Employees Union, AIXEU, an organization claiming to represent the crew members, has written to the management and highlighted a stark departure from the commitments. The union has accused the airline of mismanagement and treating staff unequally. Sources from Air India Express, however, have said it does not recognize any employees' union. Meanwhile, the regional labor commissioner has weighed in and said the staff's grievances were genuine. In a May 3rd email to Air India chairman Natarajan Chandrasekaran and others, the regional labor commissioner in New Delhi, Ashok Perumalla, pointed to blatant violations of labor laws, stating that the concerns of the union are genuine. Mr. Perumalla wrote, "The management of Air India Express has not sent any responsible decision makers to any of the conciliation proceedings. Mismanagement and blatant violation of labor laws were apparent." Mincing no words, the official continued, "The HR department tried to mislead the conciliation officer with the wrong information and an idiotic interpretation of legal provision." For maintaining harmonious industrial relation, Mr. Perumalla has suggested that Air India Express set up a high-level committee to examine grievances of the employees and functioning of the HR department. He has also called for corrective measures. Stay tuned for further updates.